It's a bloated Big Brother top-down, job-protecting, money-wasting, politician-bribing, parent-ignoring, child-indoctrinating, modernization-resistant, one-size-fits-all hegemonic cartel. All right, I'd like to thank Gene and Dr. Abrams for participating. Also, the America's Worst Mom. I'd like to give a shout-out to her, and good luck in the international competition representing the country coming up. I've devoted a large chunk of my career to furthering freedom and education, as you may have figured out. By the way, also, Choice Media, we have what's called a new smartphone app. It's the only one in the country, and we sell it for the low, low price of free, and you get it by searching Choice Media on your phone. So what have we got here? We have a system that is very corrupt, okay? Just in yesterday's New York Daily News, New York City hopes to shrink what's called the absent teacher reserve. That's teachers who lack permanent assignments. You know how many there are? 822 in the city. Teachers without assignments, this was during last school year, costing the district an estimated $100,000 per year for each of them, each 822. This is the monopoly that we have. Teachers unions taking money out of teacher salaries in 25 states, whether they like it or not, and that is wrong. An example of what unions do is like last year, the Chicago Teachers Union wanted a provision in its contract to stop all charter school growth, and you know what? Rahm Emanuel signed it. They got that 4-year moratorium. This in a district with fewer than 75%, not even 3 in 4 kids graduating from high school. They guarantee no matter how good a proposal is, no matter how many thousands of parents want a new charter school in Chicago, it will not open because the unions got that in their contract negotiation. Now, let's say you're in Chicago, and let's say you send your kid to Hope High, which has a 3% math proficiency, and you might have noticed some news about your school, which came out in a story called The 20 Worst Schools in the Country, something like that. You know, you read the union stops charter school growth, what do you think about that? Well, maybe test scores don't mean anything to you, but how about something posted in greatschools.org from a teacher? I'm just reading what's there, I don't know the person. This is what's posted about that school. This is by far the worst school I've ever been in. The children fight, curse, listen to music, talk on their cell phones all day. I haven't seen one student doing any productive work. The teachers don't discipline the children. The children run the school. The principal receives a paycheck for nothing. The parents at Hope High School, how much hope do they have? How glad are they that these new options have stopped, no matter how good the proposals might be? That's what we have with this system. And it's in America today. And 59% of black American males graduate from high school. And those are our countrymen. And I say enough of this system. It's hurting millions of kids. Enough with the US scoring 37th in the world in math. Enough with 34% of our kids proficient in reading, according to the NAEP. Enough with using money. Enough with taking money out of the pockets of teachers, whether they like it or not, in 25 states. Enough with teacher tenure being spun as due process, when we all know what it really is, near infinite process. Enough with paying a great, brilliant, hard-to-find AP math, physics, or chemistry teacher less than a terrible teacher, because the terrible teacher has one added year of seniority, which is crazy. Enough claiming with the school choice movement is that it's really about greedy, nefarious billionaires. When individual parents make a choice for a charter or a voucher school, and they don't make one penny when they make that choice. That's the reality of it. And enough with saying school choice programs are taking money from the beleaguered poor district schools as if the charter and voucher schools broke in through a bathroom window at 2 in the morning and stole it from the district, as if the district made that money and it's theirs. It's not. It's taxpayer money paid to get children educated in the most efficient way possible. And so I say enough with what the system is wrought. It's a bloated Big Brother top-down, job-protecting, money-wasting, politician-bribing, parent-ignoring, child-indoctrinating, modernization-resistant, one-size-fits-all hegemonic cartel, which traditionally uses children as props to protect teachers' jobs, which is terrible for good teachers, because they are treated like cogs in the collective. And the next time a 10th grade girl is crying to me on camera about about the fact that she's viciously and relentlessly bullied every day, and no one has done anything about it. Instead of worrying about her suicide, I want to tell her about a new school choice program that will, to use her term, give her a second chance at life. Because she doesn't have to be a statistic, and just because she's in a school that's zoned with relatively good scores, she doesn't have to be a victim anymore. Thank you.